Chapter 10. This region in which Bukovlje quietly nestles was once part of a large stretch of land known as the Croatian military frontier. Created in the 16th century from land of the Habsburg monarchy, an influx of refugees, mainly from Bosnia, populated this region and were given land in exchange for military service. And this, according to Mika, is how some of the older families, including his, came originally to settle here at our end of the village. This opinion was endorsed by another villager at the far end of Bukovlje, in a part locally known as Kremen. So I asked him where his family name came from.
Od kod su Krivačići?
A Krivačići su došli koliko sam ja po crkvenim knjigama malo dok sam mogao doći do toga.
As far as I know from the few church records I've managed to look at, we came from Bosnia, from Eastern Herzegovina. So during a period of 500 years, people left Bosnia, escaping from the Ottoman Turks, and settled here between the two rivers, Mrežnica and Korana.
I naselili se taj kraj između Mrežnice I Korane.
The village takes its name from the Croatian word for beech or bukve, and certainly the woods hereabouts are predominantly of beech, with the occasional magnificent oak breaking up the monotony. Curiously, an earlier name for the village was Grabrovac or Grab, a Croatian name for the hornbeam tree, which is very similar to beech. Now just one small cluster of houses retains this name, including the house where Stef lives. Exactly when this name change occurred is unclear, but clues can be found in old family trees listing the addresses of the village's inhabitants. It seems that the name change was gradual, as there is considerable overlapping with the use of both names. But this change more than likely happened sometime in the 19th century. Around us there are two principal families, the Fudorich family, of which we have almost become honorary members by living among them, and up on the hill, behind us on the part of the village known locally as Tsari, where reside members of the Domšić family. The Fudoriches are mainly concentrated in one house, and as the family expands, so too does their home, with the addition of rooms at the back of the original dwelling, and recently an extra floor built on top. According to Mika, the Fudorich family originated from Bosnia, and was one of those given land in exchange for military service. But this was probably before written records record at the moment, since the earliest traces in their existing family tree, dating back to the 18th century, appears to show a family well established in these parts. The origin of the name Tsari or the Tsars is unknown, but it can possibly be guessed at. Since the Domšić family occupy the higher ground, it is easy to believe that this family arrived first. The two roads that service each of these families loop and face each other, and between them, fields straddle the valley in narrow strips, like the fingers of two outstretched hands reaching across the divide. Our arrival in the village some 16 years ago was somewhat more prosaic. While looking for a flat in Zagreb, I turned by chance to the page for weekend cottages. My finger alighted on the first advertisement, and I encouraged my wife to call the owner to arrange a viewing. Having taken a couple of wrong turns, we followed an unlikely narrow road that twisted around a few houses and skirted a couple of ditches. We asked anyone we saw for guidance, and fortuitously we came across a character who turned out to be Mika. He became our guide, and having shown us around the property, invited us to join his family for lunch. We left several hours later, enveloped with a good feeling about the place. This was our first introduction to the generosity of the villagers, and the memory we hold of that first day has stayed with us.